First of all, thanks for attending. Thanks, Dr. Hamoud, for the invitation. I'm Dr. Abdallah Rajab. I'm a pediatric surgeon in a Ibn Sina hospital. I have nothing to disclose. The talk will be going through a couple scenarios. In the beginning of the presentation, will be more focused about in the clinic, what will come. As we know, you are the first line for treatment. And I was just discussing before we start, that's so difficult, and that's one of the challenge we face when with the patient coming to our side. It's when he have a different idea, try to take it out and with the new idea. And that's an art. If we don't know, we say, we don't know. And that will help a lot and take a lot of the time when we discuss the patient. So just to start with, unfortunately, children, they're not small adults. They keep saying it's the same, but they are small. No, they're not small. Size make different as not the age, for the vital signs, fluid requirement, and a lot of things extra. The one point we used to say for everybody, and the same I think you are sharing with us since you deal with a lot, dealing with children is dealing with the whole family. It's not an adult, mature, competent. You will tell him what he needs to do and he take all responsibility. You have a lot of situation, you are only the mother or the maid bringing the child. So you are in this situation the same as when you are feeling. So how can we know or suspect there is a pain? The child have abdominal pain. That's the most common scenario coming to the clinic. They said he's like, you know, I suspect he have pain. What the sign would show there is a pain the child have? And as I said, it's difficult when you have 2-month-old baby, how you know there is a pain. 1 year, till up to 3 years, they have to some awareness. And that's what we'll face with some of the diagnosis, which we have to be high index suspicion. We used to say this word all the time. Eyes see what the brain know. So as a physician, if I don't know the information, I will not direct the question or of the patient, elicit the information, I will not make any action for it. So that's what we call it in our like medical language, medical knowledge. That's how we can anticipate. We make our differential diagnosis based about the information we get. So that's an important part. How we suspect abdominal pain in the infant, like at that age, they are crying all the time. Some people say it's a crying part of the infant, but they give him milk. And that's the normal response with the mother. When the child cries, they will give him something to put in his mouth. Till he's refusing of the feed. The cry is staying all the time. Irritable, meaning he's not the usual. And we used to believe who's taking care, either the mother, grandmother, the maid, the one who's following the child, there is something wrong. And that's we keep saying, no matter what level, what we think, when this is a resistant, somebody take care for it. Like, you know, the one who's seeing the patient, the child, you should take respect for this word in the beginning. Flexion of the thigh and the abdomen, you see all the time is flexing. That's indirect sign there is a pain. So we go back and we used to see this one from our level as a surgeon, to pediatrician, general practitioner, medical student, history, then history, then history. Now with the new era, everybody will be jumping to do a lot, jumping to MRI. CT scan, ultrasound. We are the one who ask for the test. We are the one who is doing the investigation based on history. History, 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 then physical, then investigation. So just to keep abreast on that. As we say, that's all the basic. Try to keep an idea for them, trying to ask about all the condition. For children, their pregnancy history is important. If they are traveling, anybody sick in the home, anything unusual, trauma. Child abuse, these are two things we see it more frequent in the last 3 years. Like when we just joined back in Sina, when we just back to Kuwait, we see a lot of hidden insult. And that when we have the child protection, Dr. Munir Khawari, she's the head. And that's the time when we start, we have couple complaints. Personally, I have two incidents I was asked about this situation. And that's an important part to keep an eye for it. Past medical nutrition, gaining weight, that's an indirect question. All the time we ask it, that's how the baby growing. That will give you a lot of answer about things. That's a simple question, will give you indirect, like, you know, is he growing? Is it? And then that's the same time she will start saying a lot of things, a lot of information which is irrelevant. Why the patient coming, she will mention to you. Trauma, we say it, family history, travel, that's also an important part. Going for examination, the same, general inspection, looking for the most of our thing, the abdomen or the head and neck. Level of conscious, baby is crying. That's normal to be baby irritable. Like, you know, sitting, you have a baby sitting in your clinic, not moving. That is not unusual. They'll say they are polite. In the beginning, they will be sitting, but then he will try to move. That's the normal. Abnormal to see the child or like he's a 4, 3 years or 2 years, and you're examining, he's not crying. They have reaction to the stranger. These small details can give you, again, to focus for where you are going for it. Vital signs, it is different, it's important. Again, back of the basic inspection, palpation. Rectal exam, I always put as a slide. Rectal exam and genitalia, they are part of the examination. We get a lot of referral, and that's an important part. They will say complaining itching, blood in the stool, and do need the family get, and we ask them, and the family will come. They volunteer to say this. Believe it or not, I went to the clinic. I said he have blood. He didn't touch it. He didn't see the baby. He didn't examine, like, because when we come and we look local exam, he said why the other doctor didn't examine, and that's one of the things we try to give it as a feedback. We say, it's part of your examination. Like, it's not only auscultation, or just try to look, because we'll give you an idea. Most of the time, most common thing we'll say is a fissure. Most common part of the most common reason for rectal bleeding, no matter what the age, is fissure. They have either from a small baby cleaning a lot, have diarrhea with the wives, they will make a scratch, or older baby have constipation. That's the most common thing, and you can see it and you can treat it with the stool softener, or you can refer it for pediatric. But keeping it as he didn't examine, and the other thing you could see, trauma, what we call child abuse. We can see worms. I remember one of the cases when we just examined, there's worms in front of us, and then we asked, there was traveling, and they have a new mate coming. So again, just you can go back, and that's again the fundamental of history and physical exam. But we don't do put the rectal exam. That's an important part. Still for us, it will be traumatized. There's a specific indication, and that's why I recommend, if you think you need to be examined, rectal digital exam, we do it for them, because you don't to do it and then pediatrician do it, then we do it. If you're suspicious, just refer it and we will examine the rectal exam. So that diagram can have, all this have abdominal vein. All this in this picture, left lower lobe pneumonia can give, DKA, UTI can give, not everything surgical, but that's to keep our list of differential diagnosis. We have a lot of things going around, and just to be aware from it.